Did Michigan's 109th Congressional District adopt Sharia law, and did this lead to banning of bacon and the requirement for women to wear burqas in public? No, that's not true. It is all part of a fictional article made up by a satire site that tries to fool conservatives and Trump supporters into sharing ridiculously over-the-top false news so their fans can then mock them for it. It did not happen. It is not real. The story originated from an article published by America's Last Line of Defense on August 8, 2018 titled, Michigan, Sharia Zone, Immediately Bans Bacon, Requires Burkas in Public, which opened. Quote, following the recent decision by Michigan's 109th Congressional District to adopt adherence to Sharia law as well as traditional Waipipo law, County Commissioner Art Tubels took to the podium to announce further plans, a full-scale ban on bacon within the district, and compulsory wearing of a burqa by all females in public. Indeed, as expected, this news proved controversial. Dearborn's $200 billion Allah Justavanish Mosque was surrounded by protesters, and the phone lines were jammed with angry potato pancakes. County Pastor Jonathan Regarp tried to calm the crowd down. End quote. First of all, there is no 109th Congressional District, not in Michigan nor anywhere else in the U.S. Michigan currently has only 14 of them. There is no Sharia zone either. Waipipo law is a slang term meaning white people law. Art Tubels is an anagram for Bust a Troll, the owner of the site, and pastor, Jonathan Regarp, has a last name that is just the last name of John Prager, another writer of the site, in reverse. There are several other hints the story is fake, for example the notice in the header that says, information you probably shouldn't trust. The site comes with a clear satire disclaimer at the bottom of each article. Quote, satire tilde sati e renth use of humor, irony, exaggeration, or ridicule to expose and criticize people's stupidity or vices, particularly in the context of contemporary politics and other topical issues. If you disagree with the definition of satire or have decided it is synonymous with comedy, you should really just move along. End quote. The owner and main writer of the site is self-professed liberal troll Christopher Blair, a man from Maine who has made it his full-time job to troll gullible conservatives and Trump supporters into liking and sharing his articles. He runs several other websites, including patriotpost.us, dailyworldupdate.us and nofakenewsonline.us. Sometimes he is also known under his nickname, Bust a Troll. A second man working on the sites is John Prager, as revealed in this earlier story we wrote. Articles from Blair's sites frequently get copied by real fake news sites who often omit the satire disclaimer and any other hints the stories are fake. Blair has tried to get these sites shut down in the past, but new ones keep cropping up and he keeps knocking them down. If you see one of his stories on a site that does not contain a satire disclaimer, assume it is fake news. If you do see the satire disclaimer, it is of course also fake news. We wrote about americaslastlineofdefense.org before. Here are our most recent articles that mention the site. Fake news, number 14, Democrats arrested for rigging elections. Fake news, van full of illegals not caught voting in Ohio special election. Fake news, breaking, Michael Cohen not caught on tape colluding with Hillary Clinton. Fake news, CNN did not fire Jake Tapper for assaulting Eric Trump. Fake news, Eric Trump did not get in a fistfight with a CNN anchor, nobody went to jail.